Hi, this is Dallas with all my favorite things from the screen, and although season 2 of Only Murders in the Building has ended, and they haven't even started filming season 3, if you know me, I still got lots of videos planned, including my favorite moments from the season, and we've got a cryptic clue from John Hoffman, one of the show's creators, that there's an overarching villain that runs across all the seasons, in the same vein of Moriarty. Moriarty is one of the most famous nemesis of Sherlock Holmes, and it would suggest that some of our loose ends and storylines all the way back in season 1 that kept us wondering will be answered in some fashion. So we will ponder about those, and of course we'll try and figure out who killed Ben Glenroy. But before we can do that, we have to figure out how and why. I need to announce the winner of our giveaway for $50 on official Only Murders in the Building merchandise. The winner has been chosen, and it is Amanda Woods. Congratulations, Amanda. Just get a hold of me on any of my social medias. They'll be linked down in the description below so we can get you your merch. Please be on the lookout. We'll have another giveaway soon. But now with that out of the way, let's get into the video. Now, I know when I say, how was Ben Glenroy killed? The obvious answer is that he was poisoned. But in what manner was he poisoned? Of course, it's too soon to say anything for sure, but looking over the few minutes Ben was on screen, we might have an idea. When someone is poisoned, it's often done secretly, like Jan poisoned Tim Kono. Likewise, I think Ben was poisoned with a drink. I've done a little stage work in my younger years. Now, I'm no Howard Morris, but I know before performance, most actors drink water, and if it's not water, it's tea. To be specific, non-caffeinated tea, often with lemon or honey. It is a staple of the stage. When Ben gets out of his dressing room, you can see multiple teapots in the background. Now, of course, this could just be some random set dressings on the table, but I like to think that they were placed there as a hint to what killed Ben. Something else, and it may be even more of a stretch, but what if the fog on stage? You know, the fog that gives us that mysterious film noir feel? Activated something that Ben ingested. It's one thing to show fog on stage, but we see a stagehand fanning the fog. Could this be to ensure that Ben ingests this fog? This could very well just be a member of the crew doing their job, but it's highlighted. But this is the moment Ben first coughs, and it's right after the stagehand fans some of the fog. Now, I could be completely wrong. It doesn't look as if it hurt too much. He is weak rather than looking as if he has some issues breathing, though he does cough a few times. What do you guys think? Is it too early to throw out ideas? Could Ben Glenroy have been poisoned by tea? Is it too complicated of an idea to have something he ingested activated by some substance in the fog? Let me know down below. In the next Only Murders in the Building video, we will go through everyone at opening night and take some guesses on their connections to Ben Glenroy. That's all I have for today. My name is Dallas. Thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you on the rooftop.